lórúkọ tó wà tó jà ayé lọ wá mú mi débẹ̀ yé ọlọ́run
ògbó. Ìbéèrè mi lọ́wọ́ gbogbo ènìyàn tó ń gbọ́ mi báyìí, ó ní wípé níbo gan ni à ń lọ lẹ́yìn ayé? Bí a bá ṣe tán nínú ayé yìí, ó níbìkan tí a ó rè é, ìbò gan là ń lọ lẹ́yìn ayé. Àárọ̀ ló ń gbọ́ mi, ọ̀sán, ìyálẹ̀ta tàbí àṣálẹ, ìbéèrè mi lọ́wọ́ rẹ nìyí. Àkọsílẹ̀ fi yé wa nínú Bíbélì wípé Jésù ni ọ̀nà.
Was a very diligent woman, a disciplinarian, and of course she died at age 98 and none of her kids died. That's the grace I'm asking Almighty God to give to me, to believe here in the, on the land of the living, and then not to lose my kids. That's the grace. She's a great woman, to God be the glory. She lived well. God will rest her soul.
Mama is a mother for all, in all application. Talk anything good about mother, everything is embedded in Mama. Mama Yad, as we call her in our days, stalks all the life of the young ones during his own time. And in that, he tried as much as possible to give us the word of elders, which we are all enjoying today. Mama is good. We are praying that what legacy Mama has left, she will continue to shine and shine on the children itself and the people of Agawe. Mama is one of the elders that has gone in Agawe, no doubt about that. We are going to miss her, but may her soul rest in perfect peace.
Mama, ladies and gentlemen, coming over. Impresario, the one and only, eminently qualified, the writer, the poet, the author.
I would say that the unit that I've been in the family during Mama's time should continue to work stronger and stronger. They should all try as much as possible to embrace peace and love among themselves after the Mama's death. We are so rest in peace.
Oh, my God. Mama is, I mean, Mama was a woman. One model of a woman. Very warm, very welcoming, loving and well loved. Not just by her husband, but by all those that have been touched by her life. Mama is an iconic woman, one that is very special to us in Agbaye, to Ijebu people, and to the whole of Ogun State and Nigeria. She is a model of a woman that should be imitated by all women. We don't want her to go, but it's better that she is survived by those of us who are her children. And we are certain, I am very sure, that she will be well received by her creator. I wish Mama a blissful sojourn in paradise. Children need little or no advice. They've been brought up in the best tradition of raising children. You know, all of them, without exception, are doing excellently well in their chosen professions. So I hope Mama's children will continue to grow from strength to strength, to the glory of God and the prosperity of mankind.
Excellent woman, a role model. If you take into consideration what is happening today, Mama is being celebrated by virtue of her good deeds. We thank God for the children that she left behind. She has handed over to them those role motives to take a charisma to the next level. And everything is more like radiating, more like a glamour as far as this environment is concerned. My only prayer is that by the time that we have cause to go, the legacy that we have cause to leave behind shall never perish, but to be promoted by the children that we leave behind. So shall it be. Amen.
Dr. Alex Onobanjo. Mama happens to be a devoted wife. a mother in Israel, and she was a devoted Christian. My mom did not just nurse all her own children, she took care of every child that comes her way. Whether within the ministry of the Lord where her husband served, or outside within the community. She was a fantastic woman. You never hear anything bad from her. She was always very prayerful, always praying for all of us. And I have no doubt God answered all her prayers. As you can see, she did not lose any child. She ended up having children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and great-great-grandchildren. And God bless her with long life, 98. In this day of Nigeria, 98 is not easy. I can only pray that God will grant her eternal peace and she will rest peacefully with our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you. It's the children to stay where Mama put them. Mama put their feet in the house of the Lord. And they should stay there. And for as long as they stay in the house of the Lord, then I can assure you that everything will be well. Because that is Mama's way. And Mama happens to be a fantastic woman. Thank you. That God should grant her eternal peace. I have no doubt she's going to be resting in the bosom of our Lord. And I can only pray that everything she's left behind, God should bless it.
My name is Bolaho Adibalogo, Dr. Bolaho Adibalogo, and I am the chairman of the Living Team. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I will not do this on my own. I will call on one of the most distinguished members of the Living Team to make the presentation on behalf of the club. I will call on Dr. Olashupo Alade Olabiwontu Jose Maria to make a presentation to Otuba Adoni Okunfe on behalf of the club. Dr. Adibalogo, please.
Bless you. Bless you. Bless you.
Thank you. track now. My mother, then her, then Mama Yad. You know what? When I was growing up, once a week, I got to eat at Mama's house. I would tell my mother that I want to go and fetch water. My mother would fetch water. And I want to go and fetch colder water from Mama's dad's house. But I went there to eat. So once a week, I got to eat Mama Yad's food. That's all I can say about Mama. Fantastic woman. No hair to her at all. Everything his. That's why she lived to be 98. We gotta learn how to live like that. Share love just like Mama did. So they're just, all they know is they heard about Mama, Mama, Mama. We need to share love just like Mama and her children. I said, if you have, you know, like you have a team of 11 people, if you have 11 Mama in the cycle, beautiful. That is a community.
I wanna do that. Oh. Thank you. Adumo Bitty Doctor.